group of volcano volunteers from right here in South Florida heading to Guatemala to help survivors of that recent deadly eruption.
And there are a lot of them. As Local 10's Nicole Perez reports, these first responders, they are ready for anything.
Miami-Dade County first responders once again stepping up and putting their lives on the line to help those in need living through the dangerous mudslides caused by the Volcán de Fuego in Guatemala.
Whether it's medical, whether it's recovering, whatever the case of our knowledge, our expertise, our experiences from being firefighters.
President and founder of the United Badges of Honor, Lourdes Sanchez Breton, traveled to Guatemala to be briefed on what needs to be done before bringing her team on board.
We just go ahead and get to ground zero wherever the disaster or the devastation has occurred and try to help the less fortunate and displaced individuals.
Leaving from Miami International Airport, her team consisting of Miami-Dade firefighters and Miami-Dade police volunteering to take this trip despite knowing the rough conditions emergency responders are dealing with in the country.
To assist them in the search and rescue and the recovery of those that are still missing and those that have been deceased.
The death toll rising to 109, with at least 197 people still missing since the explosive eruption.
With the tropical storms that they're getting, it's affected and it's created mudslides right now, and it's been washing away villages.
United Badges of Honor will now assist in the search and rescue efforts in Guatemala and do whatever they can to help save lives.
We go try to help humanity. If we do this on a daily basis, we serve and protect. How are we not going to help those that need the help when they need it?
In Miami, Nicole Perez, Local 10 News.
And the help for Guatemala doesn't end there. Miami-Dade Commissioner Jose Pepe Diaz and all these volunteers, they loaded up 18 pallets packed with supplies today onto trucks out there in Doral. The donations included canned foods, toiletries, medicine, masks, and all kinds of gear from local fire departments. It's all bound for some of the hardest hit areas.